After that, the New York Times released audio and an editorial board meeting with Trump to back it up. Senator Markey will be away on offense against Senator Ted Cruz, calling him a football.
Here's little boy Pug.
Chief White House correspondent Ed Henry reports from Manchester, New Hampshire.
As Hillary Clinton preps for her third debate, her campaign is getting shakier. With South Carolina Democrat James Clyburn telling the Washington Post today, if Democratic Socialist Senator Bernie Sanders wins Iowa and New Hampshire by a little, it may not matter. Though the influential African-American congressman added, quote, if he comes out of there with big victories, hey man, it could very well be a new day. Today, Clinton did her fifth interview on MSNBC in 2 weeks as she grows more worried about progressives flocking to Sanders on issues like health care.
Basically, what he's doing is saying,
hey,
we need to start all over again. Let's get up and replace it.
Sanders dismissed the attacks when Fox pressed him at a news conference about Clinton's charge. He broke a pledge to not run negative ads.
You're a Pug, all right. Oh, my goodness.
The flashpoint, the Sanders ad blasting Clinton for being too cozy with Wall Street, leading to cries of outrage from her camp.
Where'd your buddies go?
Today, you see that Bernie Sanders has launched a negative television advertisement against Hillary.
Sanders said the ad is factual, and his legions of fans who waited a few hours in line to see him speak at Dartmouth College loved his attacks on Wall Street, though they struggled to explain how he'll pay for expanded health care and free college education.
I mean, based on the attacks on speculation that you mentioned, on
Wall Street
speculation. Yeah, on Wall Street speculation.
Like, think that'd be enough money?
Continues to focus on the general election, slamming Donald Trump on the Tonight Show.
Okay, well, he's a lot more obsessed with me than I am with
him. Trump just went through another high-profile debate, of course, while Democrats will clash in South Carolina Sunday night after a busy NFL playoff weekend, so a lot of people may not be watching, which could be what the DNC wants.
Right. Ed Henry in Manchester, Ed, thank you. Coming up soon, I'll talk live with Republican presidential candidate Dr. Ben Carson. First news with some of our Fox affiliates around the country are covering tonight. WRLH in Richmond as the U.S.